What could I be missing? Let's see if there's anything around this area before I continue on. Oh. That's right, he had something, didn't he? Okay, maybe he doesn't have anything. Oh, there's a cat here. Hello. Actually, I don't think I've ever scanned this room. Nothing. All guardians have been completed, we've done a lot of side stuff. No mandatory puzzles, but let's see if there's a city anywhere nearby that I could just, you know, get information from. I think the Ark is nearby, so I could probably bum around there and see what's up. Oh yeah, there's Balak Rise. I've never been there. Okay, so north of the Beskar Ruins. Every time I start the stream, I try to go there and forget. Where is Beskar Ruins? So north of Beskar Ruins, past the dunes. Maybe around here? No. She said that it was in a place where no one could land. So it's probably up around here. And knowing my luck, there's gonna be a lot of encounters. Hey, there we go. Finally found it. Alright, what do the people have to say aside from this guy who I need to buy a bunch of things from? I haven't seen glass a lot, so I don't think that's much of a niche. Everybody has wings, so no. Who's in the bar is the question, aside from a dog. Maybe the scientist had this and mixed it. I suppose bartending and chemistry is roughly the same. Both involve alcohol and mixing things, possibly for consumption. Well, that was pointless. Nothing here either. Actually, I have Jeff with scan, I should be doing that. Here we go. Thought so. Hey, Migrant Seal, sweet. Cooking is just chemistry that you can't die from by eating. Yeah. That is true. Oh my god, there are so many things. Jeff cannot jump up a staircase with his radical sneakers. That is very disappointing. when you're checking up the telescope. Remember a grown-up getting cussed out after you caught spying on something. Okay. This must be the arms shop. But I don't care about that. I'm gonna go here and steal the obvious chest that he's been hoarding. And mini carrot. Useful. Anything in here? No. Actually, wait a minute. Let's see if the arms guy has anything to say. Arms will activate when people meld their minds with them. See how much noise. Oh, wait. If I can't jump these with my radical sneakers. There we go.
Anime cowboys.
With radical sneakers.
So, did you want more migrant seals?
I got one.
Wait, really?
Yeah, there's Where? One here. There's one here in Balak Rise.
Balsak Rise.
Yes. That's kind of what it's named. Hey, a grab bag. We could possibly fix someone, maybe. We're not gonna fix anyone. The level balance is so fucked.
Every Jeff has his day.
I don't like this. Isn't that Virginia's, No, that's a very different person. Just looks the same from behind. Everybody's talking about this mysterious spyglass. It's so bizarre.
Ooh, like, the spyglass.
It's like this place is famous for its weird spying potential.
It's on the roof.
Anything back here? Kinda. Alright, let's see what we could steal from here. Nothing. What? So how does your scarf float like that, Jeff? Maybe this... No, this is a... I could come from this room from anywhere. Models, books, and pens and papers slid to the top of a candy-colored table. The gunslinger catches your eye. The crimson arm one-shot is all it's needs. The pioneer drifter of legend Alan Smithy coined that famous phrase. No written records of his life survived.
You may remember Alan Smithy. No written records of his life survived. He's the guy who wrote like 90% of the signs we've
read.
Yeah.
Some say he went to be a pioneer. Huh.
Some say he just went and fucked off forever.
That sounds more practical. Also, I'm pretty sure I just saw Sora upstairs. Ooh, a duplicator. So it was worth going down that way. Got a cool story and a duplicator. Though we haven't found much reasons to use duplicators lately. Down here, then up here. I think there's one more. Yeah, right up. Oh, the bird has it, which means we can't get it. Ever heard of Gunnershaven? Oh, this is where we were supposed to learn about Gunnershaven.
There are a lot of places you could learn about Gunnershaven.
Ah, yeah. Alright, let's see what this telescope's all about. We've been hearing about it a lot. We can't use the telescope. I don't know what the reason why they would tell me about this and then we can't do anything with it.
Yeah, I mean, it's strictly prohibited, man.
Do we guys
just look at stars, that's all.
I'm guessing it has to be like nighttime or something? Which I don't think is a thing in this game.
It's not a thing, what are you talking about?
I don't know. I just feel like with all this talk of a telescope, it had some plot significance.
Hey, speaking of plot significance, you know what we should do?
The plot?
No, what? No.
Oh, well,
go back
shit.
To Boot Hill and talk to Armengard.
Oh yeah, we started there and I had no idea why. I'm gonna stay here real quick though, just to refill my ECN gauge. Just in case. I got a feeling that this is gonna be important eventually because they keep alluding to a telescope and a crater, but we can't seem to trigger it yet. Alright, so Boot Hill. Where's our great little lazy device?
The orb.
You said talk to who?
Armengard, no, little girl.
Oh, the maid.
Maid?
Yeah, she's a maid. Well, she's dressed like the one. Music box day. It's amazing that the seemingly random array of bumps can play such beautiful melodies. Still hope there aren't a random array. Okay. Good to know.
Yeah, it's a new day every day. I just wanted you to read it.
Ah, I see.
I told you it wasn't plot, I just wanted you to go read the new things she had to say today. What the hell are we doing?
Well, last stream we went and got a bunch of migrant seals, much to my dismay.
Yeah, no, I mean, I can go get you more. You want to do more puzzles?
Is there any migrant seals that aren't puzzles?
Yeah, I mean, I was in the middle of getting you to them, but then you went and decided to go do a puzzle, and turned out it was for a migrant seal.
Alright, what's a migrant seal? I think we could get to, like, 10 and then we'll stop.
I mean, I think I could get you a few more than that, but probably like 12, 13 or something.
Alright, if they're easy enough, we'll go and grab them. You got coordinates?
I'm just making you get world map ones.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Let's start off at 7,550, 7,950.
So, 7,000s.
Yeah.
7,000...
Since there's a bunch of stuff on the map you couldn't get till you had the item scanner. Now you do. Why not take full advantage of it and get more than just Justine?
Sweet 7,000s. Said 7,000... What was the X coordinate? Oh. 7,550, alright.
I put them in the chat when I send you to them, because I know that way you can use it as a reference.
I seem to have landed in a poor spot.
I mean, it's not hard, Wang. Come on.
Should be right about here.
So bad.
Nice. Alright. Where to next?
Oh, you already got it? Okay, yeah. Stream delay, right? That's the thing. Okay, now we are going west of Laxisland.
Well,
your destination is at 15902, 18210.
That's not too far off, but we have the airship.
If you have an airship, I don't give a shit how far away it is. It's an airship.
What? What? Oh, it's a puzzle.
Puzzles everywhere.
Alright, let's take a look at what this is then. Well, the screen kind of blinked and then we got moved to the side, so I was really confused as to why
it's
that
because
happened.
Because you were sitting on top of it.
10 out of 20. 3-star puzzle.
Which one is it?
10.
Number 10. Time to go look up and see what it is and not tell you what that is.
I think I have an idea of what it is.
It was number 10?
Yes.
Let's see.
Oh, I can't pull boxes from... I can't pull stacks of two boxes, so I have to do, I have to do what they want.
It gets you an item. It's kind of a weird one. It's not terribly useful, but it's nice.
Thought this was a migrant seal.
Could be a migrant seal. I mean, migrant seal's not terribly useful, but it's still kind of nice to have, and it is an item, so... Now, it's not the one I was leading you to, but if you want to go ahead and do the puzzle, you know, be my guest. I'm not going to stop you.
I think I might have screwed this up already, but...
You said that at literally every puzzle we've gone to, Wayne.
No, I could continue this. A little goofy, but I can continue this. Tetris!
Distinct feeling you're going to end up having like three blocks at the end of this or something.
I think I've already messed it up because I can't move any other blocks. Yeah, this is botched.
Legend came into. Oh, come on.
Welcome back to puzzles.
Welcome back to puzzles.
Are there no other migrant seals in the world map?
I was leading to you one and you just came here instead, you ponce.
It was at the exact coordinates you told me to go to.
I would have told you if it was on a puzzle. I mean, I wouldn't have told you if it was on a puzzle, but I didn't tell. I told you I wasn't making you go to a puzzle. That's not the coordinate I gave you, Wayne.
Yeah, I'm 200 off, which I should learn how to read. I thought 200 would be nearby. My mistake.
200 is not 600. Get off the plateau.
There we go. Alright, next one.
Okay, I'm pretty sure that I wrote it down. Let's see, yeah, there we go. 7,570 and 13,770.
If we go south, we get to 1,300.
Mm-hmm.
So 13,200 down, which is relevant. And if I go west, it should decrease X.
Yeah, you might want to go back and do that puzzle later, because it's for a pretty decent item.
13,770... 75,70... 13,770Y... 757... We should be atop it, but it's not appearing. Like, I got the coordinates right, right?
Looks like it. Let's see.
I think you already snagged that one.
It's possible, because I know we got a few of them yesterday.
I think this is the Baphomet Hell.
Possibly, if it is, fun. But, I'll say, why not skip it then? You've got 11, that's enough for now. Besides, if you need to get any more that aren't on the map, you're going to have to go back into dungeons.
Yeah, so we've covered all the basic ones?
The basic ones I would call ones in dungeons, but yeah, we covered all the ones that are easy to get.
Now, where was that?
Yeah, I know, I made him go through a bunch of them. We went over the one he couldn't get, and he was like, good job, Navigator, at me. Then he went to a puzzle. We got a migrant seal out of it instead.
Yeah.
So good job, Navigator. Yeah, bitch at me, see what happens.
Let's see if we can take on that puzzle again.
If you want to. I mean, it's easier than the one you did last stream, by far.
Yeah, it looks like it's a situation where I have to put the block in the right place for the, for all every single one but one block to dissolve.
Kind of. I mean, you just gotta predict what's gonna happen when you push them together.
Let's take the yellow one here and see what happens. There we go. This is the pairing right here that's gonna mess with me. I have to put the silver one there, because then it will fix things. That goes the gun show. More like the block show.
It's how blocks the gun show.
What?
What?
Oh, I see what happened. It's the same mistake I made before.
Doing literally the same thing got me the same situation? Man, what is this?
I think that also killed the puzzle.
I'm laughing because that sounds almost like a dark side philism.
Yeah, I think that screwed the puzzle because there's no way I'm going to get that last one.
What a real brain buster.
I thought I had the right idea initially.
Well, I'm going to do my usual puzzle thing with you, which is to go get a beverage, and if you need help by the time I come back, then I'll help you.
I do have a yellow, but the yellow's the one I'm not concerned about. It's the white, white one. The one that's going to be left over. Oh, I see what you're getting at. Use my spare yellow to get the white. But right now there are five on the board. I suppose I can I use that bottom one? No. I have to delete the bottom yellow, the bottom white from that one, or else I can't get the yellow. I got a feeling I might be able to MacGyver this. It's gonna be way more circuitous, but I think I can manage it. I'm gonna need a spare red though, which I don't think I'm gonna get. Yeah, so, I got a distinct feeling that this is hosed. Yep. Hosed through every fault of my own. Because doing that green one before just kind of fucked it all up. This yellow, maybe cascade effect, I believe. Yeah, that's the result we want. The only issue is I don't think any other result gives that. Yeah, I do this, and it's the same thing as before, where it'll stop just short of the two greens. there one that gives you a byproduct of a green? No. It's all the same. If I do a yellow here and a white here, I'll get a white and a yellow. So I think I want to do that next. That gives me a null value where when I'm done, I'll have a, I still have a yellow and white. Now, by the end of this, I'm going to need to have a green and yellow, or green and red left over. So I'm gonna be using two whites for this, I believe? Yeah, I would need two whites for this, which I don't have. Now I'll wind up with two greens. The issue is, do I need two greens? I think I need to bust the yellow here. Like, right here. Hello, Hollow. Welcome to puzzle solving. I'm gonna get a green after this, so I don't need this green. But I do need two reds for this. The big issue here, though, is that I have five reds. Which I could solve easily. Like, having an odd number of reds is not a problem. Except when I do that, I think I fricked it. Ugh! God damn it! Wow, I fucked that up bad. I'm gonna give this one more shot.
So is it not done yet?
I had it done, but then I misspaced and I completely fucked up.
Good job.
So this is the one I always want to do.
So I just ate like four handfuls of croutons.
Ugh.
I like croutons.
I believe this is one I want, but I had to do some kind of circuitous method for this.
Is it strange that I like to just get them and eat them like chips?
A little. But that's just me.
Delicious, Iowa.
Yeah, I need a yellow and a silver here. And I could just use the other silver.
I'm a very strange, unstable man, I'm well aware, but still.
Here, this here, get the silver, and drag it all over the place.
I get the distinct feeling you're gonna start using these puzzle room musics as your new waiting room music shit.
No. The one from Alter Code I've had a lot better waiting room music.
Uh-huh. This sounds familiar. Didn't we use this in the D&D thing?
Yes. I used it for the store, actually. Now if I do this, pull this forward, it should solve the odd-numbered red scenario.
As long as the odd number of red you have is more than two, then you're good.
Mm-hmm. Now I need to start bringing the silvers over to fix this thing over here. Wait a second. This is going to pose the same problem where we have an odd number of silver. So we're going to have we're gonna have four green and four yellow by the time we're done with this. Though I'm already seeing a problem.
I mean, I don't see a problem yet. Is this still doable?
Yeah. A little tricky, but doable.
Tricky, but... Are you know how... Do you operate well within the modus operandi of tricks?
Yes.
Good, then go solve it.
The big issue is that Tetris Attack was never my best game.
Well, this is also not Tetris Attack, way.
It's kind of similar to it. Well, maybe not Tetris Attack. I always forget which one it is where... I don't want to say match three, because I know it's not the case. But usually in situations where it's like, you should match two, but you could definitely match more than two.
Ah, yes. Match two plus.
And I could just put these pairs together and we'll be done. Or I could just run off the cliff. Whew.
Gotta not mash that button, so... Croutons are normally bad enough if you don't have anything to soften their crunchiness with yar. But I eat a lot of things I shouldn't that are too crunchy. Notably, whenever I get a bag of popcorn, I'll eat the kernels at the bottom, too. Crunchy.
God, that sounds painful.
Yeah, it can be. But I mean, if the kernels hurt my teeth, that means my teeth aren't strong enough.
And we get a tracker. The hell is this? Checks previously traveled route. What? Huh.
It does miscellaneous map things.
Weird.
Yes. Also, I was really hoping to make you do a puzzle that this gave you, like, an amulet or something, just as punishment for getting me killed in fucking Darkest Dungeon last night.
I did not intentionally do that.
You're still at fault.
Alright, what are we going to do next?
What do you want to do next?
Well, we got a bunch of migrant seals. I think we've gathered enough things to where we could start advancing the plot.
Oh yeah, we got a booster pack too, or a booster kit.
Mm-hmm.
That was nice.
Oh yeah, the map scrap is something we haven't seen.
What the fuck were we doing in the plot? It's been like a week.
An old worn-up map. Location is marked by red ink. I know where that is.
Oh, I know what this is too. You're going to the Ruin of Dreams.
I believe it's this one?
Yeah, I know where that is.
Well, I didn't go to the right place, but I found a carrot.
It's, you know that big swirly continent that's surrounding the Yggdrasil system? It's like right to the east of that.
Really? I don't remember any
But look at your map.
Oh, I think I see it.
Yeah.
Here we go. And what did they say? Which one did they say it was? It's the biggest one next to a dot.
Well, they said go scan all the islands. There might be other shit on them, too. They're islands. You have an item scope. There might even be items.
Well, for posterity's sake, we have the place located, so let's,
Yeah, God, yesterday's stream was the dumbest dungeon stream.
Yeah. Also, I realized that yesterday was just extreme bad luck, because I started a new file today to, just for, you know, casual fun, and I didn't get anywhere near as many crits or deaths or anything.
I died for your sins. Also, we derailed it incredibly hard.
Yeah. I mean, that's...
party proctology.
I think that's kind of the natural case of things with A, Darkest Dungeon being, you know, a fairly predictable thing, and B, Loco being there.
I don't want to blame this one on Loco. I think that was just... That was just the whole thing became kind of a hilarious slog about a third of the way through.
Hey, Clive, this is where your stepdad died.
Welcome to the Clive Dungeon. It's Clive's turn to get backstory.
You do kind of notice how everybody's starting to come together as a cohesive unit, though. Don't know about Jeff, though. Also, here's your favorite song.
Everyone and Jeff.
It's funny we keep bashing Jeff because I was watching Chip and Ikaronicus do their Uncharted 2 LP, and oh man, the Jeff there gets so much crap. It's almost like being a Jeff is just a magnet for torment.
Is Jeff like the male Meg?
Might be. Three times size you can
know,
see.
If you're still streaming on Hitbox, I'd be spamming your chat with Jeffs right now.
I don't know if that's a blessing or a curse.
But then again, if you're still on Hitbox, I would have spammed more Gary Busey's in there in this point since. Busey's dream.
Hitbox had a lot of good ideas, but they didn't take any effort into, like, marketing things.
And you want people to watch your videos.
Yeah. Because
you have an underlying need to be validated for your streams.
Yes. I also had an issue where half my audience just could not watch on Hitbox. That's kind of that was kind of the main reason. It's almost like the planet's evolving, like the three wise men intended.
It's almost like the plot of this game is in here.
I mean, if you were me, the plot died with Janice.
Janice was a little ass boy. He's not as important as you think.
Yeah. He was a fun villain, though. That's why I enjoyed his company.
He was literally just evil Ashley Winchester. That's all he was.
Why am I... There we go.
No... Janice is just Ashley Winchester, but evil. And Todd is just Rudy, but with an afro.
Something tells me I'm going to get burned alive if I try to win Gale Crest through that.
By the way, I'm surprised you never noticed that.
What?
That all of Todd's sword techniques are ones for Rudy used in Wild Arms 1. Not Rudy, what's his name? Keith?
No, it's Jack.
It's not Keith. Yeah, I know.
And no, the techniques are vastly different. He didn't have any of those techniques.
Huh.
Well, he might have had them in one. I mainly remember Alter Code F techniques.
Yeah. So, you should probably just use the radar for these boxes. Oh, no, you're actually trying to hit the thing. Never mind.
Oh look, ECN crystals, even though I don't need them anymore.
You're still gonna need them forever. I mean, you just have a higher bank now.
I should do.
Psycho Crack was definitely a Jack move. I remember Psycho Crack at least.
I don't think he had Psycho Crack. It was named something else though.
Wait, you're wrong.
No, I mean Todd. I don't think
no,
Todd,
Todd
has...
had Psycho Crack. That's the thing he was using. It was confusing you.
Oh yeah, these guys. We fought these guys. They're no big whoop. In fact, Jeff could Gatling out the gate.
Don't you remember Todd psycho cracking your face in the first time you fought the Schrodingers and being the main problem with that fight?
I knew it was confusion. I didn't know his name. Psycho Crack. Wow. Holy shit, Jeff. Oh. These things are strong against the water. Yeah, something tells me that we're a little bit ahead of the curve. Ocean Berry. We got like 800 of those. So I'm not going to be able to hit it down. Is there an area of equal elevation? Can I boomerang while hanging?
You're thinking.
No, I cannot boomerang while hanging. Which, I mean, kind of makes sense. Oh no, this is equal elevation. Oh wow, it's not. Wow, that's fucking deceptive. So I gotta look around here real quick. I feel like I'm missing something. Gale Crest isn't gonna work. What else do I have in my kit? I have sick boots, I have bombs, I have dolls.
So, here's the thought. Have you tried grabbing onto the net using the boots?
No! I didn't think that would... Shit.
I mean, they are rad sneakers, after all.
Wow, that's actually impressive.
They're so rad, Highway.
I'm a little sad that ramming my stupid face into this thing doesn't activate it.
The Jeff Room. You just have to clock it with the boomerang.
There's this rune again.
Yeah, I did kind of make them fight some bosses. I mean, Balakul Naga is supposed to be a lot more tough than he is, but Sandcraft's kind of silly in this game. In that once you get the Arc Smasher, everything in the Sandcraft dies anyway. Now, he did kind of get over level from fighting Loco. That did happen.
We never did find whatever solves this, actually.
Man.
Oh, it's just my dumb face. I'm overthinking this.
What if I just rub all my tools on it? It's okay, I wanted him to fight Loco, you're fine.
Loco was a pretty funny fight, to be fair.
Loco's fight was amazing.
The nano machine, son.
That's what this game is about. What if the evil in the world was nano machines?
Same property of the nano machine that were injected into your body. Can't wait for Clive to dissect a nano machine. Oh, hello, Dad.
Yeah, Werner's here to go bullshit about nanomachines some more.
Hey, it's time for context. Isn't embedded spelled with an E?
Don't worry about it.
Using the nanomachine, a single nanomachine! I can't believe Janice was a cancer.
Well, yeah, he was a fish. So if anything, he was Pisces.
Quiet, you. Did Metal Gear Solid 5 have nanomachines? I thought that was 4.
They all had nanomachines.
I don't think 5 did? 5 had parasites.
They were all nanomachines.
I mean, I
so
guess.
So you communicate it. Deep down, we're all nanomachines, that way.
The demon planet Philgaia.
Right in the demon hole.
How the hell did you get here, Clive?
He just walked in here.
No, I mean, how did he walk to the, you know, place holding his... that killed his dad? Stepdad.
He took the stairs.
Hey, a gimbal coin. Was there any other parts of that room that I just up and left? Just a dead end of a hallway, weird. An issue has arisen. Eh, what do you want, boy? You just went outside, so you don't need me to take you outside. Yeah, good dog. Hello. I know
sit,
you.
Sit, Bubba, sit.
The dog's very lonely since a lot of the people are not in the house anymore. But he doesn't know that I don't need to let him outside. There's a dog door. Yeah, I think I might have to reset that puzzle. I'm supposed to drop down. What was that, Jeff? That was really weird. Like, I have to hang down from this to activate the button, but I don't know how to hang.
No, actually, you don't need to do that at all.
Do I just need to jump?
Just jump! You might as well jump! Do, 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 do.
Well, basic jump doesn't work, though.
Radical sneakers!
Yeah, radical sneakers jump doesn't work.
You can't go down there and just jump on the button?
No. You need to hang on this, which is just too high for you to get on with a... radical sneakers jump.
Oh wow, that's strange. I thought that would even bring it back up there. Alright, well, I mean, I'm sure there's some other way to get around this. How do you get back up?
That's the question I'm trying to solve. And the only
can't
answer...
ride sneaker too?
Nope. Can't ride sneaker.
You just run off the cliff? What?
I can run off the cliff. I did that before. I'm just trying to figure out how to go from standing atop a grating to hanging, which is something this thing will allow me to do.
Actually, I think there might be a way to do this in a bit, but maybe we can look around a bit.
That's what, yeah. I was thinking, but
maybe look around a bit.
Oh, did I not go to this room? No, I have not.
Yeah. Maybe check that room out. That looks like a pretty cool room.
Oh boy, and
it's nice. It's nice to have no encounters, isn't it?
Yeah. Just open up with Gatling, Jeff. It's fine. Oh wait, these are the mimics that could one-shot me, aren't they?
Yeah. You're not gonna fight weak-ass mimics anymore.
Good job, Jeff. Amulet. This had nothing. The other room, I believe, is backtracking. Did I miss something on the way here? I don't think I did. God, this is gonna make me the ultimate lazy person. I'm just not gonna have a random encounter for the longest time. No, we've covered most of the area. So there's gotta be a way to do that puzzle that I'm just... Oh!
I wonder what enemies we've encountered in this area.
Zabos and Grabs. Grabs spelled with a Z. It's like I'm back and alone in the dark. You should be able to radical sneaker right from the button. That's what I was thinking too, but it's not letting me. It's really weird.
Yeah, it seems like you just need to go hang on the net.
Hope Shard, yeah, we haven't done Zephyr Summon and see what it does.
It hurts.
Yeah.
He power bombs his heart into the enemy. You've seen it happen to you.
I'm just kind of curious if it's the same mechanically where it's just raw damage. Excuse me. Hello, Zephyr. This is such a needlessly gruesome attack. Why is
no,
this
it's
a
great? Because it's gruesome, but also it's hope. This is the most metal attack where a giant dragon rips its heart out and power bombs you with it.
I'll have to do that for a D&D game. Clive can handle everything on his own.
So you know what this since he's just hit punching you with his heart, you know what this is, Wing?
What?
An artery punch.
Yes. The next evolution. So apparently the hitbox for this is super wonky. Please change to Jeff with his awesome shoes.
To be fair, the dragon would die in D&D because a bag would shoot it.
Yeah, red shoes are not cutting it? It's also weird because when you're on the button, you do a run action, while when you're not on the button, you attempt to jump to the grating. I got a distinct feeling that, it's not the case.
I feel like you might just be doing it wrong. Are you sure you're using the rad sneakers properly?
I don't see any other... Unless,
Are you wearing them on your feet? Hi, Chitlin.
Hello.
Hello, welcome to Jeff Jumps on a Button.
That sounds like the worst stream.
Yeah, we're trying to figure out how this is because it's not working and it's really bizarre. What other tools do I have? I don't think bombs will do it, I don't think Mighty Gloves... I feel like Mighty Gloves should do it, but they don't.
What would you do with them? You can't pick the button up.
I mean, can't I use my Power Gloves to punch them? Oh, there we go! That's really fucking weird. Okay, fine.
But the real button was the shoes you wore along the way.
Wow, that was really weird.
Okay, yeah, that actually saying that is weird. You're on the net, go fall on the button, huh?
Okay, moving on.
What was even the point? Can't step up 2 feet to stand on a button.
I have also activated a trap. I lose.
It's just timing, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, so it's not a Gilchrist thing. That means it's something else. Oh, it's Boomerang. Fuck! I'm somehow fighting a random battle atop a moving trap!
It's actually pretty neat. Why did you not cancel it?
I was trying to get to my menu when it appeared, and then I just spaced.
Jeez.
What was Brave Seal? Oh yeah, Instagib. And this is how we get 4 Dark Gems. Space Godzilla and Angry Wolf. We got another amulet, what the hell? Yeah, I need Boomerang here and... Hey, look at that. Blind Fire did it. Hello, Werner, give us more plot.
The meaning of your dual arms is nanomachine, says Werner. Or some shit.
I can't believe this guy's still in the game.
Yeah, no, he's kind of annoying.
He's a walking Deus Ex Machina. Of course he's gonna stay here until, like, the end of the game when he gets shot to death.
You haven't even seen the worst of it yet. He does some stupid shit down the line.
How far are we into this game anyway? We
almost a little over halfway, probably about maybe 2/3 through.
My god.
I was gonna say 75%, but we did kind of spend 2 streams fucking around.
Yeah, no, but it's a good thing we did. Look at these encounters you have to go through that you don't even have to bother with if you don't want to.
She spent 2 streams grinding.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't call it grinding so much as just fucking about with Loco and suddenly getting experience because of it.
We fought a bunch of side quest stuff, and we did things that we were eventually gonna do, we just did it ahead of time.
Like, fight Loco. The dread boss Loco. Dark Loco, rather. A Loco for every occasion.
Never overclock a system. Bad things will happen.
Like how they just start talking about how do we fuck up this computer?
Duran? That's a name I haven't even heard of.
Oh good, there's more villains we haven't been introduced.
There's so many villains.
Oh no, Anime Dad is mad.
Anime Mad.
Just some secret proof.
He has a really weird, like, portrait for when he's mad, too.
Oh. So this was pre-programmed to fucking explode the planet because the Council of Seven is stupid. Great.
Turns out everyone's dad was really dumb.
Now that... I forget how long ago Torpid pointed out, but now that he pointed out, like, the belts on, like, the ankles and the sleeves, I can't not see... What the fuck is that? Humbaba.
Oh man, this is a good-ass boss.
I had to do my usual thing. This looks like a physical character, so physical all the way. And a lock-on for good measure.
You should probably analyze it.
That's what I was intending.
Man, this is a good boss. Yeah, yeah, I agree.
God, it's so fast for how huge it is! Weakness everything.
Yep.
Okay.
He is weak to all elements.
Though I got a feeling shooting him is gonna cause some crazy bullshit.
Well, there's no way hitting him with magical attacks will in any way backfire on you. So, go ahead.
I'm curious about something. I know this is not going to work, but I have to try. Actually, I don't know what I'm going to do. Since everybody else can't use magic, I might as well boost everyone's attack. Of course. Had to try. God, Virginia's evasion goes to hysterical levels, it's nuts.
Man, extension hyper would be real useful.
Yeah, I know.
These characters are like 40% belts.
Yeah, this was about
an RPG.
It was about the time of belt proliferation, too. Holy shit, Clive! What the fuck?
Hyper's a pretty good spell.
And I don't have any EXP or Gela cards, which is unfortunate.
Wow, that actually did do some pretty good damage.
I can make this even more insane. Hang on a second.
Does this boss, like, pose a threat, or are we just so over-leveled it doesn't even matter anymore?
I mean, normally he does, but all it's been doing is just rubbing its head on so far, so...
The stench of death!
Oh yeah, it also smells bad.
I mean, that's kind of what I would guess looking at that thing.
Yeah, it does look kind of like a smell beast.
Mm-hmm.
Magnarize. Hit him with a spear, Gallows!
I want to just mystic a full carrot, of course.
I mean, when we have fucking, what's it called up? Humbaba Curse. What?!
That's a pretty good boss fight, right?
Oh, if I magic it, it curses me, doesn't it?
This is what you get. This is what you get for fucking getting me killed, you motherfucker.
Wow, that's dirty.
Man, it ain't so good when it happens to your whole party, is it?
I mean, you really should have known better.
Yeah, I should have.
I mean, the second you see an enemy weak to literally everything, you don't use that.
Well, an enemy you would. A boss, though. There is some...
Yeah, that's what I meant.
So we just shoot, he did.
Yep.
I think it's just magic period. It will cause him to go apeshit. I don't know if support magic will do it, though.
Well, it didn't last time. What if the analysis was a trap?
It was. I do enjoy extension.
Oh my god, just load up on gunshots. You don't need anything else. He can't do anything to you.
There is something that I wanted to do, but I don't think it's on this character. Oh well, we'll just extension distortion. I remember a spell that locks buffs forever, but I forgot who has it.
Pretty sure it's, I want to say it's, permanence. That's on Zephyr, which would be, I believe, on Clive.
Damn, Clive has a huge barrier.
probably about 800 HP worth of damage. Yeah, A14, good call, me.
Well, we have Hyper, and we have people with a lot of FP. Let's have a little fun.
He's so nice, dude, when he just rubs his head on you.
The stench of death! And a phone call.
Good.
The call, the stench of calls. Oh, what?
He used the insta-kill fuck thing.
Oh, like, yeah. Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did.
So apparently magic isn't the catalyst for that.
I mean, maybe.
I don't know.
It might just be a thing that he does, don't tell Link.
Okay.
I want him to go through this as many times as possible for what he fucking did last night.
That's fine. That is fine.
I know it is.
Everything's okay.
Everything is awesome.
So is any attack, huh? Movie.
I mean, maybe. I think it might have been
because you did that super shot with Virginia, where she just sort of...
No, that was afterwards. It was when Jeff shot him, I believe.
Well, when you think about it, it was at about the same time as the last fight. It could be like a delayed reaction to magic, so you have so many turns to hit him with weaknesses before he just jumps you with the stench breath.
Yeah, it definitely...
Just then auto-kill you.
Yeah, it might be some sort of, like, invisible countdown thing.
What if he has a rotation?
So, last turn we did death, we did one, so... Now we have to bull rush him with no damage. And I think everybody's hypers wore off because they're... Nope!
Gallo's lit, so his is probably still fine.
And I think this is where we die.
See, you tried to use magic, then they just started getting stinky again.
Yeah, I think it's any magic.
What if even the analysis was a trap?
Maybe the fact that you analyzed him triggered the stench.
Well, see, analysis is also magic. Maybe it was also a trap.
So I'm going to use only one spell, and it's going to be Hyper. Got it.
No, don't use any spells. No,
see, that would also be a spell, and therefore a trap.
You see, Wang, there's a thing called magic. You don't want to use it in this fight.
What if something, 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 a trap? We're all traps down here.
Alright, good start, Clive, good start.
Good start, he says, criticaling the enemy for 5,500 damage again.
Are they getting 2,500 from Virginia?
Still not Clive. No one out damages Sniper Dad.
Nope.
Especially not Jeff.
Yeah, no, Jeff's role is never damaged. He's not the weakest, but he is Jeff.
Now, when Gallo's dodged it before, it said something like, it's dead.
Oh, did you kill it?
Yeah. But let me tell you
how the stench of death works.
Alright.
He just does it,
There's no rhyme or reason to it.
He just does it. You actually got really lucky with him not doing that much. It just kills everybody. And the reason Gallows avoided it is because he has a personal skill that makes him immune to death. In fact, fun story, that thing Umbaba drops, the Holy Grail.
Gives that skill.
It gives you the skill, immunity to sudden death.
But why didn't he resist it before, the second time?
Good question. I wasn't watching. I just was hoping you would die again.
Let me check out his personal skills real quick.
I mean, that's just really unfair.
Not really, because the game gives you a chance to know it's coming. It inflicts the status fallen, as Yar said. And as a note, it has been giving you this item called Amulet a lot of times, hasn't it? Amulet gives you the ability to ignore status effects while you're guarding. And Humbaba,
oh, Gallus was reloading back then. That's why he has a...
Yeah, he has the amulet thing where you guard against statuses if you're guarding.
Yeah.
And they've been giving you the item that gives you that skill, Amulet, all over the place. The Stench of Death lets you know that Humbaba Curse is coming, so you can guard and try to avoid it. The game does telegraph this boss fight.
But it's he does it in the same turn, though, which means I would have to...
No, he doesn't. Humbaba Curse is the turn after he uses Stench of Death. It always comes after Stench of Death. Stench of Death does nothing, but warn you that you're about to get your butt cursed. And yes, Dan Dyrum has Resist Fallen on him, but Wang didn't put any points in it.
Has Dan Dyrum right now? I believe Virginia has Dan Dyrum. I don't see Death Resist. Oh, there it is.
Okay, so that boss was actually alright. It wasn't quite as bullshit as I thought it was.
Yeah, there's not actually any bullshit bosses in this game, except for the bonus boss, because the bonus boss.
Of course.
And actually, even the bonus boss has a kind of gimmick to get around his really big bullshit move, but you actually need to prepare for the gimmick. Because you cannot outstat his fight.
Isn't Ragu 100% fire damage?
I mean, it may be in Ultra
Ragu
Code F.
Ragu is pasta sauce, Wang.
Very spicy pasta in Ultra Code F.
Yeah, in every Wild Arms game has a boss called Ragu Ragula, I believe.
Ragula Ragla.
Yeah, everybody just calls him Ragu Sauce. I knew there was a reason why I like Clive.
Did Clive do something cool again?
He always does. The fact that he was also an archaeologist is pretty sweet too.
Also archaeologist, part of being cool, good to know.
That's not generally associated with coolness.
How would you know, Jetlin? You're not cool.
You're right, I'm also not an archaeologist.
Yeah, see? They go hand in hand. It's a given.
Yeah, this stream is opening my eyes to my own shortcomings.
I mean, your girlfriend thinks you're cool if she could sit through all of Full Spectrum Warrior.
Well, I mean...
Oh, that's a keeper right there. I can't
see that whole thing.
Yeah, I know, right? She fucking marathoned it in one day.
You know how many episodes of Full Spectrum Warrior I watched?
One.
Hopefully no, less than one.
You're right. It was about one third of the first one before I shut it off.
Good. That's exactly how much you should watch.
I watched the whole thing trying to parse what happened, and the answer is nothing. Also, I got a good look at Malik's portrait. He looks really fucking bad.
I told you Malik is the one who got it the worst. It looks like some fucking weird anteater bird thing.
Like, his 3D model looks okay, but if you look at his portrait, it's so bad.
He's like a fucking cockatiel man.
Yeah.
And Lee Holt's just got a giant bullseye in the middle of his forehead.
Yeah.
It's like fucking Siegfried just said, I'm gonna make these three look like fucking idiots.
You know, he kind of did.
Indiana Jones has about as much to do with real archaeology as I do with, like, being a soldier.
Indiana
it's just
Indiana Jones is as much an archaeologist as Nathan Drake.
Ah, good old Chitlin of Fortune.
What?
Soldier of Fortune.
Oh yeah, Chitlin of Fortune. Yep. Be an awful game.
It would be where Chitlin.
Why is there a kid laughing at us?
It would be where Chitlin shoots minorities and talks about bad opinions.
Why would I be shooting minorities in my game?
Because it's a FPS, and that's kind of what those are about in the modern day.
Well, yeah, but I figured I'd at least have like a early 2000s first person shooter to my name. Yeah, so where you can still have fun.
Yeah, I mean, if I wanted to play a shooter that was fun, I would go play Doom.
Yeah.
Oh, has it been Warner putting the flower on the grave every time I've stolen it?
Yeah, you've been stealing the damn flower every time, dude. That's exactly what happened, actually.
Excellent.
You've been stealing flowers off your mom's grave from your dad who's been putting them on there. Your missing dad who comes back into town like at 2 a.m. every night to put a flower on a grave.
That's perfect.
Wow.
He's probably wondering, who keeps taking my wife's flowers?
Did you just spin your hat to spin yourself, Werner? What was that move?
See, the thing is that he was just turning himself and trying to make sure his hat stayed in the same place while he did so.
I kept saying that this game is great because not only are the writers aware of the plot going on, there's not a lot of like anime tropes, but that's because this guy just took them all into himself.
I can't believe that 10 years ago the world was full of anime, but then the Yggdrasil project happened and they were all condensed into Werner.
It's true.
And no one remembers that there used to be anime except for Werner.
And Jeff.
he's the fucking anime singularity.
Well, see, Jeff has memories of the planet when anime was a thing.
Philadelphia.
Yes.
Virginia, you have a job. You don't have to worry about your father.
Why do you care, Virginia?
Because she was abandoned when she was like, what, 8 or 9? And that just kind of gave her a complex. Oh, now we can examine the crater that I've been hung up on for the past 3 streams!
That's why I've been laughing, because it's a place you have not... It was there. There was something the whole time. You were just there early.
Ah! And now I have to use the microscope, the telescope to figure it out, huh?
Yes!
God damn it. I hate my whimsical spirit of just rubbing my face on everything.
And I love it because I know everything is going to happen and I get to fool you.
Why do all the portraits look like they have different hair colors in the character models?
It's because of the overlay of the text box. That, and I think Virginia's design had a little bit of a change in between concept art versus in-game model.
Yeah, I mean, I can kind of see like the green hair in Clive's portrait, but I mean, fucking Virginia looks like a redhead.
I think she was originally supposed to be. But they just kind of made it a little bit...
I don't know if her hair is red or brown. I never even figured it out. I don't really think about it too hard either, though.
No, I don't know. It's just something I noticed.
It's an easy thing to notice, honestly.
Like that damn lower dress belt. What is that for, Virginia?
2000 JRPGs. Belts saved lives, Chitlin. You wouldn't understand. Okay, I gotta remember how
you've got a fucking Bahamut plane now?
Yeah,
we have a jet dragon.
We got that 2 streams ago.
Oh, wow.
We convinced a dragon that wanted to sleep to help us.
Yeah, the airship in this game is a dragon that is also a Gundam.
I have to remember
missiles with it too.
Wait, what am I doing? Why am I actively searching for it? We have an item to prevent this.
Can we get in, like, air kaiju battles?
Actually, yes.
What was the name of that place called? It was started with a... here we go,
Philadelphia. Oh, Ballsack Rise, yes.
Ballsack Rise.
It's called
Ballack Rise, but it's one letter off.
That's not the way I want to go.
I'm a child, as I find it funny.
I think we all are.
Balls in the distance.
Still can't use a telescope, so I think we gotta talk to people here.
Aren't you supposed to go to the crater?
Do we not have to use the telescope?
I don't remember nothing about a telescope.
I've been hearing about it for, like, the last stream. Why do you do this?
Because you got me killed, motherfucker!
You're still hung up on that, and I had no control over that.
I got more kills this time than I did my whole Darkest Dungeon LP. It's the only wonder that I made you a character, and 10 minutes later you died.
Atla, let's just cut the shit. You'd be doing this even if he didn't get you killed.
I mean, you're not wrong, but I can frame it however I want to.
I mean, that is your prerogative.
Exactly. I'm going to be a dick one way or another. It's just a different flavor of dick.
It's finally scannable.
A different Ballsack Rise, if you will.
And Fatebreaker's still playing.
Oh.
Yes, it is, because they know it's a good track. Also, it's another fucking Ziggurat.
Yeah. This game is just like non-stop Ziggurats and belts.
The best one is the fucking mansion in the beginning of the game. When you go back to it, it's a fucking Ziggurat on the map, too.
Yeah, they didn't. They needed something to distinguish dungeons and just decided to go for Ziggurats or something like, you know, mines or mansions.
They actually have correct mine shafts.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Gallows, can we sue someone? There was a fucking Ziggurat on the world map. This isn't a Ziggurat at all.
Gallows, I don't think organized law exists in this land anymore.
No, I mean, that's the exact opposite. This is. I mean, look where we're at. This is the Wild West.
Just as the saying goes, and the sign I saw all the time, what goes up must go down. I can't believe Gallows is just a nice supportive uncle. Actually, I think Gallows is more of the big brother figure. Looking at
How
this,
is Gallows an uncle at all?
Yeah, that's what I realized when I said it. Okay, so what do we got? We got a way down and something weird here. Also, we have to get into at least one fight to see what's in this place.
Do we?
Yes.
If you're lucky, it'll be gummy bears.
Tool grappling hook. I'm guessing this is a Clive kit?
It is Clive's final tool, yes.
Man, Clive gets all the cool... Actually, Clive got all the Zelda stuff. You got the power glove, you got the bomb, you got the grappling hook.
It's kind of the point, actually.
Okay, I see how it works then. I can't believe Clive is a Zelda protagonist.
Remember that time that Clive held a chicken above his head?
Yeah, it was great, wasn't it? Oh, here's our fight. Virginia's in danger against, fuck, what was that, The Walking Dead. Oh yeah, they are definitely Walking Dead, holy shit. Which means I can do... Actually, can I? Yes, I can, so... Mystic?
Oh, these actually are pretty cool enemy sprites.
These guys are like Zombified Virginia dads.
Yeah.
Zombified
Bear
dads.
Bear touch.
Show me the true meaning of your guns. Ah.
I gotta wonder, how the fuck did I wind up with 51 light gems?
I'm wondering how you ended up with just Virginia in this fight.
It's dangerous. An ambush.
Yeah, ambush is danger status. Anyway, you have used the light elemental flash hit to kill a lot of enemies.
I used 2, I got 4. I think I came out ahead there. Guess we got a puzzle here, it looks like.
I also feel like I should tell you that Raftina does have a spell for this.
Raftina?
The loved one.
Oh, Banish Dead, right. But I don't think Virginia has her.
Maybe, I don't know.
No, Jeff has it, because Jeff has Love and Lust.
I'm kind of annoyed that you remember it that way. I certainly don't.
You just stare-rode a billion things to death. Oh yeah, that's right. Most of the system is comprised of living and machine matter. Biomechanoids!
Biomechanoids?
Bioorganic weapons. So, the puzzle for this room was to just get plot.
I'm glad we came here.
Yeah, it's Philadelphia, also known as plot.
What's up here?
Plot?
Probably. Lucky card, thank goodness! I've been so starved for those. I have a bad feeling of this theory. Ooh, we got warp stars even though we don't need them anymore.
Yeah, they're entirely superfluous at this point, actually, because you have the orb.
I mean, we also have a dragon.
There's that too, yeah, that helps.
Man, Clive,
what have you been doing here?
The plot was that Anime Dad told us go to this place for some reason, and Clive and Virginia have speculated it's because this place has a massive energy source and demons might want it to further their endeavors.
It's a pretty bold claim.
I mean, they've done it before. Like, the very same demons decided, like, way earlier in the game, said, "Hey, look, an energy source, I'm gonna steal it." Though they weren't demons back then. Oh, don't be such a nihilist, Jeff.
This is dumb.
Everything ends. Everything.
Jeff seems like he'd really like Linkin Park.
I like the fact that whenever Jeff is sad, he hides in his muffler.
Is that what that's actually called? A muffler?
Yeah.
Scarf.
Yeah, that's a muffler. It's like a scarf, but bigger and dumber.
Oh, okay. I was just going to say anime scarf.
Yeah, I mean, you're not wrong.
Same thing.
Yeah. The only reason I know it's called that is because of Reseteer.
Reciteer, you're taking lessons about life from Reciteer, huh? Okay, well.
Well, not lessons so much as knowing what an item is. Which is just as bad.
What?
I know about capitalism on my way.
Yeah.
Okay, we've successfully moved that stack. It's good. Yeah.
What?
But what?
Huh?
What? The fuck is this thing? Chameleon Man! Oh no!
Here's your boss. Enjoy.
Where the fuck did this come from? I'm so confused. I'm so confused.
Here's your boss. Enjoy.
Oh god, what's this gimmick? Is this gimmick gonna be camouflaging me out of the fight? Wow, that thing looks dumb as hell. What am I doing? Get a card.
Kind of reminds me of the gorilla in God Hand.
Oh god, he even has an anime
the
dash.
The gorilla in God Hand is kind of great.
Yeah, I mean,
God Hand is kind of great.
Yeah, but this thing's like just missing the zipper, and that's all it would need to be the exact same.
Oh, weapon. Oh no, he has depression attacks.
The depression chameleon.
Weak to ice, but has two statuses I don't recognize. Oh, interesting. Once physically attacked, the monster will activate stealth mode. It will wear off after a number of turns. However, I do know you could do another thing. I believe this will... I think this will work, but I'm not 100% sure.
So, we use magic on him, right?
Yes. We're gonna put him on ice.
Yeah, or you can really make him weak damage.
Why did I use Water Gem, damn it?
You have weakness as a skill, so why not?
Should make him weak to Jeff.
Jeff elemental damage. On Wii damage.
Oh my god! That's a new one.
I can't wait to see what happened.
I know what it is.
Oh, he just flat out murdered Gallus. Okay.
You see, you know how rogues work in D&D, right?
Yeah. Apparently, you get a sneak attack damage.
He just totally sneak attacked Gallus.
Cool.
Man, when are you gonna learn how to fucking put Fallen Ward on shit, Highwing? They just gave you a Grail last match. Boombaba did this shit to you already.
I didn't think they'd do this back to back. They're getting really hog wild with this.
You're gonna want to start warding yourself against instant death at some point, Link.
Yeah, I think this is a wake up call.
Fucking Chameleon Man is the wake up call, not Boombaba.
Well, Boombaba could have just been an anomalous thing. This is just like, well, fuck. Gonna be this
no, they've been doing it. Justine did it to you too. It just never worked on you right.
Come back, Gallus. We need your meathead. I can't weaken him.
This is great. Fucking bumbles his way through Humbaba just fine after about 3 deaths. Going, I wonder if the trigger is magic. And then we get here and he gets backstabbed once and only one party member is dead and he's like, oh my god, this is a wake up call. The fucking Chameleon Man. The wake up call.
I think Grav works on this boss. So it really does. That's why I enjoy it. And the fact that this thing does sneak attack criticals is so disorienting. Oh, it nullifies all status except Instagib. Well, that was a waste. I parried a chameleon!
Yeah. Again, status lock. Nulls all statuses on you, except for Fallen.
Except the one we want to nullify. Great.
Yeah. Which is why bosses like to do it to you, because, see, the game, if it knows, here's the thing. The game is not balanced great, right? There's a lot of ways to break it over your knee. But the game knows that and counts on you to figure that out. So after a while, it'll start, you know, putting the screws to you. It's gonna be like, I know I'm not gonna be able to hit you with any status effect but Fallen, so I'm gonna fucking hit you with Fallen. Humbaba is the reminder of that, as he kills your whole party in one shot if you don't have that warding on.
I don't think I could steal from this guy, but might as well try. Yeah, I can't steal from him.
Can't believe you hit him with the Mondays.
I can't believe Jeff is depressed. This thing has pretty high magic defense. Yeah, someone's gonna die, but... If I have 100 FP, is it better to use lock-on or just straight-up attack him?
I mean, lock-on seems to be doing some pretty good work for you. I mean, you probably shouldn't physical attack him at all, actually, now that I think about it.
Someone will die, and I'll just pick him back up.
That's certainly an option you have.
Oh yeah, Jeff is depressed, so he needs to eat an acorn.
What?
Yeah, in order to cure depression, you need to eat an acorn in this game.
As I said in the third stream, you're depressed, eat this pine cone.
This is not an accurate representation of mental health.
This is not an accurate representation of reality, don't worry about it.
Remember Lisa when they said, depression is like withdrawal you can't get rid of. Maybe all I just need to eat a pine cone.
Wow, he really doesn't like gallows. Also, he goes last. Hang on a second. Shit, I'm muted.
Torpo, why aren't you in the call?
Huh? I had to take care of something because somebody needed the washer.
Also true. Aiden Acorn can confirm it's gone. Thank you.
I know this is not going to work, but I still have to try. It's alright, okay. Torbid.
You're good. Hey, all you've missed so far is me making Wang do more puzzles and die.
That never fucking works.
I don't prefer gathering the pine cones so much as throwing them at things, but that's back when I had pine cones. And I guess pine trees to go with pine cones. That may need context.
I wonder if Exploder will work.
I used to live in the woods. We had pine trees then, and we had pine cones, and I was told together that I'm like, I don't see the point of this. Pine cones are kind of dumb.
You gotta preserve the forest, dude.
But what does all this have to do with acorns?
They both come from trees.
Great.
Please stop trying
and
to depress Gallows.
Eating a pine cone is a hilarious mental image to me, so.
Oh! Wow! Exploder worked on the boss. What do you know?
Ah, the boss exploder.
There was another thing that I wanted to do, but forgot who has it. Oh yeah, Gallus has gravity, but he has no FP. I got a feeling this is going to be a slow fight because I'm approaching this entirely the wrong way.
What's the right way?
You say that way.
You know what the right way really is, don't you?
Off his back all the time.
What?
What did you do?
It worked!
A plan of yours working worries me.
Huh.
All we had to do was...
Oh, holy shit, it did!
All we had to do was turn him into a bomb. Imagine that.
Killer Queen, its attack has no equal.
Light the Dusto!
Wow, that was dumb.
What if we just turned it into a bomb?
What if we just turned all enemies into bombs? Huh. I never knew that would work.
Man, that was a real wake-up call. Turn it into a bomb.
Well, now we know what to do if we ever have a problem with an enemy.
Oh, fuck. Is this a timing situation?
Oh, no.
No, I might just be stupid. Hang on a second. Oh. What the fuck do you mean I can't boomerang over that ledge that's just above my foot?
I like watching this stupid fucking thing rotate around.
Let me get a treasure in the Ark of Destiny. Thank you for reminding me.
That'll be great for when we're done here. I really like this stupid device.
Damn it! Is there like a gimmick I'm missing? Because that's really closely timed.
Yeah. Yeah, you are missing a gimmick. See, the thing is, it turns back afterwards, right?
Yeah, so what do I got in...
So here's the thing. Have you tried using logic? Like a weird logic that would work, but games never let you think would work.
Hmm. What if I use my mighty gloves?
How would that help?
What? Rip it off?
I also want to see what this looks like when it comes back up.
You know, Allo, the actual logical solution would be to have Clive just stand down there while someone else turns the crank.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. But why don't you just freeze the crank in place?
Oh, god damn it, really?
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, after you turn it, mind you.
I forgot that was a thing.
That is not something I would logically think would work.
We had precedence for this, actually. But
Did we?
I completely forgot about it, though. And I missed it. Twice.
What?
There we go. That's clever. Like, it has been a long time since I've done that particular puzzle. We got any more plot here? Anything, Clive? Nothing? Alright.
More plot.
Oh yeah, Maya's not here to remind me, hey, I'm gonna dick you over with a switch.
Melody's not here to say, hey, do you think I'm pretty, and have Clive go, you're ugly, and then have her just float at you.
Wait, did we just take a lap?
This doesn't look like an old area. But again, everything kind of looks the same here, so... I don't know where we are.
What the fuck is Philadelphia even?
That's such a good question, Atla.
Well, this is definitely a new area. nothing to interact with it. Oh, here we go. I found the plot.
Thank God.
Plot is a computer. Clive, stop all the downloading.
Clive would download a car.
Clive would download a sand grip. Wait, we don't have cars. Mustang. He'd download a Mustang.
There we go.
Clive, it's not proper typing posture.
Clive, you're going to get carpal tunnel. Then how will you shoot your big-ass gun?
Crystallized energy. Much powerful version. Bring it up on the screen. The teardrop. Wait a minute!
Can't believe this old civilization was into standing desks. That's so annoying.
Man, they're bringing in all the stuff back from Wild Arms 1.
Yep. I mean, Philadelphia was in Wild Arms 1, you fool.
Was it?
Yeah.
Where the fuck was that? I don't remember that area.
How do you not remember anything ever, Iowang? What are you?
Not good with names. What the hell is Philadelphia?
This thing, mostly. I mean, what the fuck even is Philadelphia?
Damn it. I can't believe Jeff was motivational.
I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do the thing.
Oh, Jeff was also looking for the, this thing unconsciously. Oh, good. It's these clowns.
I said gem. Why am I thinking of sparkling gems, huh?
Oh, good, they're back.
Yeah, the best characters.
I kind of like Maya and Todd better than anyone in our group.
Yeah, Maya's a pretty good character, and Todd's
well, Well, let me tell you what. You're in luck, because the game is about to be more about them than your characters.
Thank God.
Like, Maya's a pretty interesting character, but Todd's very nothing.
He's the Afro Samurai.
Todd is Jack with an Afro, I told you.
I don't like that they have a cartoon cat, though.
It's Schrodinger's cat.
Wasn't the cat just named Schrodinger?
No, the cat had another dumb name, but it's the cat of the Schrodingers. That's the joke.
Right. That was the name of their group. Which is stupid.
This is a very strange scenario.
Then she turns to the sun and says, "Courage is found at your feet," said Adam Smithy. You look at the sign that says, "Looking for a shortcut can lead you astray."
Oh yeah, the cat's name is Shady. I forgot about that.
Shady. Not a bad name for a cat, I guess.
So I'm guessing based on that clue, we have to go to a town near Claiborne?
You want to go to Claiborne, so you can talk to people in Claiborne. Let's see, what does my GPS say about this? Also, you know what you probably should do?
Not be using my ship?
I mean, not really, no. Have you checked out the garden in a while?
No, good point. I think I got about one more plot segment in me, and then I should really end the stream because I have to be responsible tomorrow.
Oh boy. One more plot allocation.
3 carrots, 9 berries.
Oh, that's good, Garrett. You can also go get the chest in the Ark of Destiny, as someone in chat said.
That's true. I really wish Teleport Orb was just one of our tools.
So now that we have the Flying Gundam Dragon, is there any point to the sand ship that we spent so long getting?
Yes, actually. We used a lot of it, I believe, last stream.
Sand ship?
Yeah, the Shagahad.
The sand ship. Well, we used it to blow up a big, annoying beast and get a lot of experience out of it, and also a key. Really, though, to be honest, once you get the Arc Smasher on the ship, there's nothing they can fucking fight you anyway. And once you get the Jet Dragon, you really don't need the Sand Ship for much.
Can we really do something here?
Yeah.
Like, I understand that this is supposed
to
be a place
over to the side, Wang. They're overhangs.
Oh.
Did you not see those?
I saw them, but I thought they were just, like, fluff and not relevant to the grappling hook.
But this is a good game, Wang.
Yeah, I keep forgetting that they think of these things. Oh, it's just another carrot.
Just another full carrot. You can never have too many full carrots, Wang.
So many carrots. I'm just so used to modern games where visuals have no relevance to the gameplay at hand. They're just fluff. Well, I should say...
This game is designed a lot like the shell. There is no fluff detail. Everything will get used.
This game is good and the shell is not. Don't even...
What shell? Okay, so we were going to... There it is.
Do you want to go do the thing?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember. I was trying to find out where the town name was on the teleporter map.
Claiborne.
Heard your story about the Guardian Isle of Desire. Yes, we've heard of it. We own it. Dog, tell us about this rumor. Oh, hey, it's Jess, partner. I could change the one word that defines your existence, your name. Oh shit. There's an old crumbling ruin near this village. It's said to see things fall into decay. Okay. I wonder if Pike could rename our guardian forces. A lot of rumors about the abandoned tower of the Northwest. Is there anyone else around here I could talk to?
Is this the only reason we came to Claiborne? Just to hear rumors about a tower?
Yep.
Another ziggurat to go to?
I think we already have it unlocked. Aren't they talking about Kadingal?
No.
Okay, so northwest then.
They're not talking about Kadingal this time.
73. Money goes to Clive, always. Ultimate bullet. Speaking of...
Yeah, I mean, like they said, maybe someone nearby was spreading a rumor about an abandoned tower full of treasure.
Maybe you should set up the thing where they can't kill you.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing right now.
Okay.
Crazy.
Yeah. It's not a big deal, it's just a ruin. It's another tower, though.
Yeah. Just one more ziggurat for the pile.
The pile of ziggurats. The whole bag of ziggurats.
Wait, doesn't Jeff already have that skill? We'll reset sleep, because sleep is a rather benign skill. Jeff should have... Yeah, Jeff has status guard. And Clav also has it, so if there's more insta-give, we have some protection against it.
Yeah, hopefully. I mean, I would certainly be putting points in it now, since the game realizes your folly.
Northwest, so this way. Hello, horse.
I'm really glad Highwayne got the wake-up call of Lizard Man.
Chameleon Man.
sorry, I forgot his name.
That was such a fucking Chameleon wake-up man. Call.
The Explosive Chameleon Man.
I cannot believe that worked. That was such a fucking wild curveball out of nowhere.
Oh, this one's not a ziggurat. It's an actual tower.
Yeah. Who's on fucking point now, huh, Chitlin? Maybe it's a good game and knows your shit.
So, this way?
So, Caging Tower is not full of loot, by the way. It's a tower designed to catch monsters. You're actually going through a fucking roach motel right now.
What the fuck?
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you didn't just go up and sniff one, did you? Yeah, you did.
He totally did.
I gotta sniff it.
You actually don't.
You're in a roach motel and you are the roach. Good job.
I mean, I am a pest. Harsh sound can be heard from this device. From sphere drifting around the floor seems to be drawing energy.
Hey, what if you just blow it up? How about you explode it?
That looks magical. It might explode more than we want.
It's fine, we exploded it.
Yeah, just blow it up. A lot of problems in this game can be exploded.
What's this?
It's a bad lesson to take away from this game.
Potion berry and... Oh, wow, I was expecting a mimic fight.
Imitators.
Thank you.
Can't just explode all your problems away.
Yes, you can. What problems can you not explode away?
Rent.
Oh, you just aren't using explosives, aren't you?
Just explode the foreman or explode the manager and become the manager.
Wow, you've gotten to a point where you're actually starting to use ECM again, Wayne.
Yeah, now that we've hit that point, I should probably,
I mean, you're only using one per step now out of the 40 you have, but still.
Radical sneakers! For a Gellicard.
What about rent? You're not using a large enough explosion. What if you used one large enough to get rid of your house? You would no longer have rent at that point.
I mean...
You also wouldn't have a residence, but...
Yeah.
That's a different problem.
That just creates a whole new problem that we can't explode again.
You can't just blow up someone else and take their residence for yourself. You're just overthinking this shit.
What's behind door number two?
Yeah, but then the cops come and talk to you about the man you exploded. What are you going to do then? You can't explode
AP
the cops.
Ammo, what?
You can very much explode the cops. They're quite
Increases
explodable.
The chance of nullifying
My God,
a target's defense.
This is going to end up being on Twitch and other things later, possibly YouTube. I'm sorry. I do not mean that in all seriousness. I support our troopers. I do that for a living. In fact, I don't explode cops.
I think Clive would really enjoy AP bullets.
Yes, he would.
Let's equip Hope with a bullet.
That seems oddly poetic.
How much do I need for a death knell? I need 8 total.
I like how that too, just it's a bullet. We found a bullet.
We found a bullet, but we're not gonna put it in our gun. No, we're gonna give it to our guardian who will teach us how to penetrate defenses.
I thought that Philadelphia had an item that I was looking for you getting, but I think it might be a little later.
Hello, you folk.
Well, time to consult the tapes. Let's see, where is it at? Oh, no, it's not. I think it's over here.
I missed the pocketbook.
Yeah.
Apparently.
Yeah, okay. We need to wait until Dimroot Path for that. You've got about 2 more dungeons to go before then, so probably be soon.
Dimroot Path sounds like a Grimrock level.
Yeah. Also, Maya's gonna get in our way for petty reasons.
Yeah, well, what'd you expect?
Naturally.
What she does.
That's her entire role is to be the Team Rocket of this game.
Yeah. They're a good Team Rocket, honestly.
I'm glad you understand. I understand perfectly. We're gonna fight. Damn it, Maya.
She's not using her gimmick either. That's really bizarre.
Oh, no,
her gimmick is being fucking Calamity Jane over here, right?
Well, before she would transform into various different cliches, but now she's just Maya now.
Actually, there is a gimmick this fight.
Well, I mean, there's gonna be a gimmick this fight, but she didn't henshin a go-go this time.
You'll see the gimmick. It's gonna be, like, right away.
I hope it's a brand new insta-death thing that Wang's not prepared for. That would make my day.
Let's set Todd's hair on fire. There we go. Oh, they get a special technique! What?!
I told you there was a gimmick.
I feel like you just bully Todd every fight.
It's not our fault his hair is flammable.
The gimmick wasn't too strong though, but it's pretty
even
badass.
Even the fucking cutscene for their combo attack, Todd's hair is still on fire.
I kind of like how Maya had no part of that group attack.
Yeah, when I said there's a gimmick, the gimmick is that Maya is not involved at all.
Oh yeah, she didn't attack at all. That's bizarre.
If you think about it, she's not doing anything. It's everyone else who's hurting you.
So all you have to do is take out one of these characters and they can't do that attack again.
That is correct.
Cool.
Once you take out one of the 3 characters, they can no longer Wild Punch.
I guess who's
going to
be?
Which is, as Broken Box SA said, another Wild Arms 1 reference.
What was the attack called?
Wild Punch.
Hmm.
Which I believe is also a movie.
Possibly.
I just love how Jeff is squaring off with this cat. This is so goofy.
He finally found a worthy opponent.
Magnemite's distortion, people don't have anything they can do with Gallows right now. Feeble Mind Todd.
Todd doesn't even use magic attacks.
Yeah, you should feeble mind the other guy.
No, feeble mind makes you more vulnerable to magic attacks.
Oh.
Well, never mind then.
I love how Todd has like no animation for. Well, he has one. Never mind. It's getting stronger.
Oh.
Todd's hair is still on fire.
Love it.
Bye, Todd.
We have escalation in their wild bunch.
Goodbye, Todd.
You can't hug your children with wild arms.
And
I hate you, Atla.
I know.
Now the cat's next on the chopping block. We know what cats are weak against.
Oh, by the way, when you take one of them out, Maya will start getting involved.
Naturally.
Oh, of course. Can they do a new wild bunch with Maya?
No.
Oh.
No. Maya can't do combination attacks. Everyone hates her. She just lives to annoy other people, really.
I'm fully aware of how 100 FP equals damage buff. I just don't feel like I ever need it.
Shady is still pretty weak, and as you see, he's still weak to water because cat. And Alfred over there, he's still pretty tame. All he does is throw a silly bomb at you that does less than the fucking Wild Bunch did to each character.
No. Flesh has a weird sound effect that's awfully similar to enemy death. Uh-oh.
That's the sound of a flush.
That's the sound of a minigun from God knows where, aimed at Jeff.
Oh dear.
Ow.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah, she does that.
I mean, the gal could change into either, like, a kung fu girl or some kind of anime witch by reading a book. So that doesn't really surprise me anymore like it did the first time.
Just seems a bit...
Over the top? Yeah.
A little bit.
Where else is she gonna get it from?
I'd rather she just conjure something out of thin air rather than...
I mean, she effectively did.
Yeah.
Let's just bully this kid while we're at it.
Well, I'm gonna shoot your brother. You shot my Jeff.
No one would avenge Jeff.
That's true. You done bombed my Clive. You bombed my Jeff instead.
Got Alfred has
a secret pocket. Yeah, okay. That's pretty good.
It really is. Yeah, it could also be just a Trigun reference.
I like how you shoot Alfred so hard you trip him.
Was Trigun even a thing when this came out?
Yeah,
Trigun's been a thing for a long time. It's old as shit.
This is like, what, 2002, while Trigun was like mid-90s?
For some reason I thought Trigun was newer than that.
No, Trigun is an old daddy anime.
Oh.
It's a dinosaur anime.
I don't know shit about anime.
Boy, but still.
Fucking minigun.
It's like Yu Yu Hakusho tier, I think.
Yu Yu Hakusho was good up until that fucking meathead became the antagonist. Then it started going into like DBZ territories.
Fucking meathead. The big Toguro?
Yeah, Toguro, that's his name.
That wasn't terribly far into it.
I think that was like the start of season 2, because I remember it being 52 episodes before that dude appeared.
Then they all went to the Soul Society and it became terrible, oh no.
Yeah. Bleach.
Let's not go into that, by the way, please, I don't want to, thank you.
Yeah. Oh, she actually does Calamity Jane now.
I was waiting for this to happen. This is her big attack that she does this time.
Calamity Jane. She has every gun, and she aimed them at Jeff.
Would you not? I mean, yeah.
What? Where did you get that?
Remember when I said that Calamity Jane was? I was telling you, Calamity Jane was. It was a name of an attack for a reason.
That's pretty good. Too bad Jeff is too swole.
This is what you get for being level 50, motherfucker.
That did not do nearly as much damage as I thought it would do.
Because Jeff is 5 levels ahead of the curve. Because when we fought Dark Loco, he gave us
5 levels ahead of everyone else. You as a whole are ahead of the curve by far at this point. You're like, I want to say, Jeff is like, I want to say, like 15 levels above where you should normally be.
And Jeff killed my in response. Oh, good. Phase 2?
Oh, good. She's back for cosplay.
My cosplay superpowers! The gimmick! The fight is over when she's like, no, this is stupid. Stop it.
Yeah, it's like this entire fight was needless.
You're being stupid.
Ow, fucking Maya with the sick burns, jeez.
You're so naive, you're being stupid.
Oh. I can't believe you got parried.
Yeah, no, you can't slap her because you're fucking naive. She knew you were gonna slap her because everyone tries to slap Maya. She's fucking annoying. You think you're the first person who's tried to slap me?
Like, this is
she's
the first...
developed a built-in immunity to slapping.
This is the first rival character in a good while that I've enjoyed.
You can't reach. See, the trick is that after you parry, just keep pushing her arm. I slapped you anyway! Ah, they're like the fucking 6-year-olds. It's great. This whole thing has just an escalating level of dumb in a good way.
Okay, so now we have puzzles.
Oh, good.
Thank you, Rad yes. Sneakers. As the ground shakes, you hear the sound of a motor off in the distance. Power has been restored.
Press the on button.
Let us go to the third floor. That is not going up. Oh.
Congratulations, it's the boss, the elevator.
What is this thing?
The trick was that you were not on the third floor. You were not on the second floor. You were higher than that.
That just goes back to where you were.
Yeah, we need to go higher because the
You were on floor 5, you fool.
You were on. You started on floor 5. You need to go down.
You know, we got you a thing and a puzzle today that lets you know what floor you're on.
Fuck. Yeah.
Or we could just leave the dungeon. Whatever you want to do, Highway.
Fuck. I want to get trapped by so many fucking balls is apparently what I want to do.
Welcome to Balls 3D.
This looks really annoying.
It is. How do you feel about RNG balls?
Oh, is this RNG? I thought it was...
No, they just show up wherever they feel like.
Nope, no, Clive, I want you to use the grapple hook.
Weird, because the first room you didn't have much of a problem with them, but this time you just run into every single one.
Yeah, I think they're in placements, just that they kept going so fast that I couldn't quite memorize them. Now, where's the... There you are.
There's nothing to memorize.
That too. Fuck. Okay, we got a lot of money, and mimics. I was wondering when these dudes would appear. Every dungeon.
Ah, good old party mimics. I missed you.
Everybody loves the party mimics. Hell, left charm dude. It was heal. So let's just use Lust Jaw.
I love these guys.
These guys considered? Yeah, they're all one part of one team. So what if we extension? We don't really have anything that would be good for extension. I'll extension Hyper. That's always a good opening act. What? How did Virginia just kill one outright?
It's almost like you're overleveled for this.
Seems like it.
Un poquito.
Growth egg, yay. Let's give someone more summoning potential. Six, four, yeah. For Jeff. The elevator was there just in case the Schrodingers were an issue. Oh, okay. The thing is, though, they weren't because we've wasted 2 days fucking around. Oh, god damn it, really?
Everything looks the same in this dungeon.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, this looks fun.
Okay. God
damn
it.
Why are we here in this horrible place?
We heard a rumor about a thing called a teardrop.
Oh, fuck you.
What? I mean, I didn't lead you astray this time.
No.
One in plot, it's here. Enjoy it.
What happens if you get shrunk all the way down by the balls?
Nothing.
You just sit there until you fucking fix it.
Oh.
No? Okay, good.
That is less interesting.
Yeah, it's not great.
It is merely a time-wasting mechanic, which is why we should have bull-rushed the device to disable it.
Yeah, but you had to get treasure.
I honestly didn't even see the device until, like, the very end.
Yeah. I mean, you could have looked around, but there was treasure.
You could have looked around at any point in time, but there was treasure.
Oh, whoa! A Chaos Emerald!
Treasure blindness is a real thing, and it affects millions of people worldwide.
That is not the teardrop? Not the one I remember.
That's no teardrop of mine.
Thank you, Maya, for realizing how overly eager Virginia is. It's almost like she has treasure blindness.
It's a real problem in the world of Phil Gaia.
Here, cat, we could sacrifice you.
Fetch, cat. The best part is that's exactly what she's doing.
Oh no, the cat's in a box.
Yep. Turns out it was a trap.
We had to put the joke somewhere. So we came here
as a dick. Even to our own team.
Shady, you're not poisoned yet. I don't think there's going to be any gas.
Well, it's more Schrodinger's box things. Instead, they killed the cat.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I totally forgot about that. Wait, wasn't it radiation, not poison gas?
Whatever.
Can't have radiation in a Wild West setting.
That's
doesn't
true.
Make any sense.
Good work, cat.
So we did all this for nothing.
just runs away from her.
Oh, well, he doesn't like me anymore. Vi is just a huge dick to everyone. I wasn't even sure anything was out here. Oh, well.
Everybody right now is just saying, God damn it, Maya.
Literally everyone.
So where's the real teardrop? In the enemy's hands. Wait, what?
Yeah, Maya's also dumb and standing where the trap was.
Wait, why is this relevant to the three wise men? What does Maya have to do with this?
Also, good question.
Wow, the frame rate's chugging because there's just so many people here.
The gang's all here!
Oh, because she has the information, they're gonna kidnap her.
Yeah, because they want the teardrop, and she knows where it is.
So why is she here?
Because
this was closer and they thought it might be here on a lark.
Great.
They were being lazy and came here because it was shorter.
Can't wait for Maya to bust out like a fucking bazooka.
She has many guns.
Yeah?
Why didn't she read one of her books and transform to something that could break out of this thing?
What if you turn into a bag that does not need air?
Or what if they just teleport your dumbass away?
Also, notice how she's suddenly starting to preach about the good of the planet just when the prophets show up because she knows it'll fucking annoy them instead.
Maya just...
She, just like 5 minutes ago, she's like, Regina, I don't care about the planet, you're fucking naive. And the prophets show up and he's like, are you the fools trying to mess with the planet? She's just trying to piss everyone off.
She's got a neck for that, to be fair.
She's trying. She has to be purposely trying to piss everyone around her off. Yeah, thank you, Yarb. Maya should have listened to Berlitz. She looked for a shortcut and has led her astray.
Yes. Perfect. I can't believe Alfred's an arsonist.
You can't?
We knew that for so long.
He's been doing nothing but throwing bombs at us the whole game. I don't mind asking, but kids these days are fucking weird.
Why the fuck did you just say exactly what Gallo said?
Because I remember this scene.
That's a good point. How could you tell where they were going?
I'm your Sherpa on this adventure leg.
No. I mean Todd. How the hell did Todd see where they teleported?
They went straight up. We saw
those
that.
Are some really nice sunglasses.
He's got Google Glass with built-in directions.
Phil Gaia Glass.
Far southeast. Are you gonna take the teardrop? Because if you are, I'm gonna have to fucking cut you. Yeah, I think this is about a good enough time to stop, because I actually have to be responsible and head to sleep like 30 minutes ago in order to get up early and go somewhere tomorrow.
Fun. trademark.
Yeehaw.
Gotta take a 1.5 hour long test for employment.
Good luck with that, of course.
Yeah.
Yep.
The only issue is I have to print up the entry ticket, and I have to get directions, so I won't be going to sleep just yet, but yeah.
And see, I had to take a test for employment. It's called an interview.
No, this is a apparent exam.
You know, I've got into an interview before and said, hire me. And right. I thought, maybe if I say hire me, only one or two things could happen. Either they'll like my audacity and hire me, or they'll say, that's what we're here for.
All right, good night, everybody.